Caesar's cipher is also called shift cipher, because each letter is mapped to another letter by a fixed amount of shift. So if we represent letters as numbers, meaning A is 1, B is 2, and Z is 26, then this encryption scheme or cipher can be represented as the letter, meaning the integer, plus n, the fixed shift amount, mod 26. Here, the shift amount, n, is the secret or the key. And obviously, there are only 26 possible keys. Therefore, it is easy to break Caesar's cipher because you only need to try 26 possible keys. A generalization of this scheme is to allow arbitrary mapping of one letter to another. That is, we no longer require that a letter is mapped to another letter by always the fixed amount of shift. Now, of course, we need to avoid that two letters are being mapped to the same letter. The mapping, meaning how each letter is mapped to another, is now the secret key. Can you tell how many possible keys are out there? Meaning, how many possible ways to map one letter to another? The answer is 26 factorial, because there are 26 factorial number of ways to map one letter to another. Please note that n factorial is much larger than 2 to the n. For example, 26 factorial is approximately 2 to the 88, which is much larger than 2 to 26. In other words, this is a very huge number. If the attacker attempts to use brute force or just blindly search all the possible keys, it's going to take him a long time because there are 2 to the 88 number of possible keys. So what should the attacker do instead? Instead of trying all possible keys, an attacker can analyze the statistical frequencies of letters to break the schemes. For example, in English, the most frequently used letter is E. And if in the ciphertext, the letter X is the most frequent, then there's a high probability that E is mapped to X.